right document. It's one little simple document that explains this business from A to Z. You don't even need any other training other than that document, and you go through it over and over and over again. It shows you how to pique. It gives you the language, how to pique someone's interest. Now, I can't remember it all offhand, but it gives you the exact words to say if you run into somebody. I mean, there's some, like if you're, it's somebody, let's say you got a coworker, and you know they hate their job. An easy peek to them, hey man, do you see yourself doing this for the rest of your life? Heck no. All right? Then you just go right to it. Or if you're at a restaurant, all right, and someone's your waiter or waitress, and you could ask them, hey, do you see yourself doing this for the rest of your life? You know, that's an easy peek.
After they serve you.
Huh?
After they serve you.
Definitely. It's at, and especially if they, and again, because you're in a hurry, right? So I do this all the time. I'm like, oh, I can't wait till I'm finished. All right? On the way out, they getting it. All right? I don't say nothing the whole time. All right? I leave them a nice tip, okay? And then you can ask them, do you keep your income options open? All right? Very simple. So there's a whole bunch of little one-liners where most people ain't going to say no. Then that's when you just go straight, or they gave you good service. Man, your service was so great, your personality. And what happened? Oh, thank you, thank you. If I send you a DVD to show you how you can make a lot of money, would you be interested in watching it? If I would you. And then all you do at that point, the next step is confirm the time. When will you be able to watch it for sure? Oh, 8 o'clock tonight. 8 o'clock tonight. All right, so if I called you at 9, you'll be watching it for sure, right? And they'll say yes. All this is written out in the script. And that's it. Then if you told them you was going to call them at 9, you call your upline, hey, I got somebody who's supposed to watch the video at 8. I'm going to call them back at 9. You're available for the three-way. And that's it. Then what does the leader do? I do it every time, and this works like a charm, okay? What did you like best about what you just saw? All right? I say it every single time. It works like a charm. So let's just say if you watch the video, what did you like best about what you saw, knowing you know the business?
Presentation.
Like saving money on gas, make money, global business. Saving money on gas. Oh, yeah, me too. I don't care what they say, I say me too. I like that too. All right? Like saving money on gas, me too. Like making money, me too. I like it as global, me too. All right? And then I talk about that subject for a quick second. Yeah, me too, man. Me and my wife saved like $300 a month. As soon as we start using it, I hand it out to a lot of people, they saving money. All right? Then the next line is this. Sean, from a scale of 1 to 10, being 1, you're not interested at all. 10 being, sign me up, Chris, let's build this global empire together. Which number are you? 10, great. All right, say if I was on the phone with Glenn, sign Sean up, and then when you finish, call me back so I can welcome Sean to the family. And that's it. If he said anything other than a 10, if he says 8, 9, or 10, I'm going to say the same thing. 8, oh, great, man, looks like you're ready to get started. Glenn, sign him up, all right? But anything 7 and below, then I'll go into the next part. Well, Sean, what would it take to get you from a 7 to a 10? Need to try the product, need to see the comp plan, whatever. All this is in the script, all right? But your part of the script is, would you like best about what you saw? Me too. Tell a little story. Scale of 1 to 10. And then I've done this one. I've taken a 4, all right? One of my friends, personal friend, it was funny because it was the first time we were testing it, right? I read, this was before we put it in the back office and I read the book. And me and my leaders, we were sitting there trying to strategize for the next year. So we're in my basement. And we see the script, so I called my buddy, one of my buddies, Cole from Facebook, bless you, that I haven't talked to in years, and I did that to him. I said, would you watch the video? He's like, yeah. So he's like, I'll do it right now. So when it was over, I called him back, and I went through the scripts, and then I sat there, and he was like, I'm a fool. I was like, y'all, what am I supposed to do now? Everybody in the room started laughing. I didn't even know. I was acting like an idiot to him on the phone. I know he was sitting there like, what is Chris talking about? All right. And they were like, well, go to the next part of the script. And I was like, okay, well, what would it take you to get you from a 4 to a 10? He was like, oh, I need to use the product, da, da, da. Then I went a little bit further on the script. And it was my first time doing it. So I said, well, how much money would it take for you to make a month in this business for you to be interested? He said, oh, about $1,500 a month. And I said, well, how many months would you give me to get you to $1,500 a month? And he's like, 6 months. And I said, well, how many hours a week would you be willing to give? He said, 10. I said, so if I can show you how to make $1,500 a month, By you giving me 10 hours a week in 6 months, would you get started right now? He said, absolutely. And he was a four. Something about that money, y'all. If you can show them how to make that money, they all in. Okay? So, and all that's in the scripts. All right? The thing is, if you don't know the scripts, then you can wonder why you're not having success. And I'm telling you this, I hardly ever have to do that, the money part at the end, because I've never now, I don't get anybody below an eight. And the number one problem that we always had was, oh, I'm an eight or a nine or a 10. I'd be like, well, or, you know, what would it take to get you to there? Oh, I just need to get my money together. It's always the money. But that was before the 150 kid, right? Now, on the 150 kid, somebody tell me they ain't got the money. I'm going to be like, Slim, you need to go find that money tonight. Go borrow from somebody, all right? Go for $150. I said, I want you to just pretend like you lost your cell phone today, because if you lost your cell phone, you'd be at the store before they opened tomorrow morning with $600 in your hand. All right, you'll find that money, all right? So, guys, I'm telling you, the scripts are that easy. And all you got to do, what y'all need to do is get everybody, bring a printed copy. When is your next training? When are you guys training?
Wednesdays.
All right, on Wednesday. Why don't we all agree to this? On Wednesday, everybody print that document off the back office, all right? Or I got it up on the Wealth Enterprise website. I'll write that up too. Just print that document off and read it before you come, and everybody, when y'all come here, start practicing. Just practice it, all right? Because practice will make people feel comfortable with doing it. And you can mess it up all day. As long as you wind up saying, if I give you this DVD, or if I send you this link, or if I give you this CD, would you listen to it or watch it? As long as you say that part of it, you're in.
I hit something by mistake.
Now that thing doing its own stuff. Alright, so I think that did that come from
the
question?
The reason I came up here was just to tell you something.
Uh-huh.
He wouldn't shut up, so I
that's true.
What I've learned more than anything is we don't care if somebody says gives you a educated no. If they're fully informed, if you spent, say, an hour telling, and they learn everything else about this business, from how the product works, the company plan, everything, and they say to you, I'm just not interested, that is fine with me, because at least they're giving you a no answer of something that they're educated about. I cannot stand when they say no to you, and they don't know and they don't what they're saying no to. So back to the key. How do you get them to watch an entire presentation? Half our problem is they never even get there. You start talking to somebody, you start telling them about how the product works, and within 2 or 3 minutes, a guy's saying, not really interested. That's frustrating, isn't it? Because they don't know what they're saying no to. You've got, it comes back again to this. The most important thing of this whole thing is piquing their interest. Get them interested enough that they will want to see a full presentation. Now, let me just give you an example. Just from personal experience. Some of you know the answers to these questions, so don't blurt it out. But when I first started, I signed up in the first 2 weeks. I made a goal. I was going to sign up somebody every day. Okay, that was my goal, to just go out, at least present to one person each day and sign somebody up. That first 2 weeks of business, I signed up 17 people. How many people do you think I had to talk to sign up 17 people. Mm-hmm. Literally, how many people do you think I had to talk to sign up 17 people?
A couple hundred.
200, yeah.
200?
Yeah.
Any other guesses?
I'd say about 350.
I talked to 17 people. Mm-hmm. I was 17 for 17. I didn't talk to 18 or 19 or 20 people. I talked to 17 people, and 17 people signed up. You know why? They were so excited to see what I had to show them, they couldn't wait for me to come to their house. Because I piqued their interest like no other. And they said, they were begging me, when can you come and talk to me? And they knew full well I was coming, so I had their full attention for an hour, 2 hours. Laid out the whole presentation. When they saw the whole big picture and everything involved, of course they signed up. Why wouldn't anybody sign up in Syntec when they see the big picture and how this is doesn't cost you a dime to get involved. It is no risk and no brainer. Let me tell you how I did it. It was this simple. Didn't even tell them what the product was. Now, this is another company, but this is how I did it. I told you earlier that I never believed in network marketing, right? Well, that's the truth. I didn't. Didn't believe in it. And I had one day, Kurt Entz, who's my partner in Syntech, called me one day and said, I want you to come to my house for a presentation on Tuesday night. You know what I said back to him? I said, are you kidding? Are you doing network marketing? And he goes, well, he stumbled, and yeah, but I want you to come and see this. And I went, oh, gee, I'm not going to do network marketing. Are you kidding me? And, but what do you say to a close friend? You support him, right? I said, all right, I'll come over. In my mind, I thought I'd go over, put in my time, say thanks, you know, have a cookie or whatever it was, and leave. Okay? That was my intent. And of course, when I went over there and saw the whole presentation, I was sold, and for the first time, joined, after many, many years, joined a network marketing company. All right? That being my story, that's all I told people. I'd call up somebody, and I never did it face-to-face. I picked up a phone and called somebody I knew and said, I got something to tell you. A friend of mine called me up and invited me to come to his house to a network marketing meeting. Invited me to come to his house on a Tuesday night. And I said back to him, this is my conversation I'm having with this guy on the phone. I said back to him, are you kidding me? Are you doing multi-level marketing? And the guy said, well, yeah, but I really want you to come and see this presentation. So what do? He's a friend, you support a friend. So I went over there to see the meeting with the intent that I'd just show up, put in my time, and then leave. But when I got there, you wouldn't believe what I saw. I was done. That's all I had to say. And what do you think they said back to me?
What'd you see?
Because here's a guy that was against network marketing that said, you're not going to believe what I just saw. And they said, well, what'd you see? And I said back to him, well, I can't just tell you. I got to show you. You got to see it for yourself. Okay, well, when can you come? You want to come over right now? Come over. And that's how simple it was. Because they were so interested by what affected me that I couldn't believe what I saw. I mean, come on. Granted, I kind of set them up. But it was the truth. I said exactly that. You're not going to believe what I saw when I got there. And everyone said, well, what did you see? And I said, you got to see it for yourself. Can I come over and show it to you? Absolutely. And when I went over there, they knew it wasn't just going to be for 2 minutes. They were waiting to see the presentation that I saw. I gave it to them 17 for 17. I'm not lying. My first check, I told you, was $22,000. So I did that same thing for the next, for their people and their people. And my very first month, that's what I walked away with. Because, one reason, I piqued interest. You see, once people see the whole presentation, from start to finish, and see the big picture, hardly anybody says no to this. The problem is they never get to that whole presentation. They get bits and pieces. And all they ever hear when you're talking to them is network marketing. And that's a turnoff when you say the word. We say network marketing. You know why? Because MLM is a turnoff, isn't it? Multi-level marketing is a big turnoff. You know it's kind of, okay? It's been ran down our throats for so many years that those words, pyramid, multi-level marketing, is a turnoff. That's why people in ministry use network marketing. It's because people hate the multi-level term. You've got to come up with some type of piquing interest story that could be exactly like mine, if you wanted it to. I came to a meeting, didn't want to come. Dale asked me to come to a stupid meeting on a Saturday morning. Dale asked you to come to a meeting on a Saturday morning and you didn't want to come. But crap, Dale's a friend. Or you work for Dale, so crap, I better come. He's my employer. I better show up and put in some time. It's worth my job. So I show up for a few minutes. I went to the meeting. And thinking, I'll just put in my time to please my employer and be on my way. You're not going to believe what I saw when I got there. Mm-hmm. That would pique my interest. If I knew you, you said to me, I wouldn't say, oh, that's cool, yeah, and walk away. I'd say, well, what was the meaning? What was it? The worst thing you can do is say, well, let me tell you what the meeting was about, and start spilling off all this stuff. That's the worst thing you can do, because you're giving him bits and pieces of the presentation. Say, no, you got to see what I saw. Can I have Dale come to your place